Hello everybody, welcome back to Operation Musketeer. I'm Aftertaste and this is going to be turn 3 for the Commonwealth Entrance. We'll get right on into it. We start with the Commonwealth's technology roles. We have three roles. We're going to be going for radar, anti-submarine warfare, and improved construction. We succeed with radar and we succeed with anti-submarine warfare. So that's a pretty good tech roll. Okay, purchases for the UK. We have 15 to spend. We're going to be spending 13. We're going to be purchasing 3 infantry for 9 and 2 militia upgrades for 4, which brings us to 13. So we'll have 2 remaining. The FC are going to purchase a AAA. They'll have 1 remaining. And NTAC are going to upgrade their minor factory to a medium factory for 7, taking them down to a total of 2. That's it for purchases. Okay, we're going on to no, I have no combat movements, so we're going to go over to non-combat movements. So let's see, we're going to move this coastal sub from here to here. This transport's going to use one strategic naval move to go down here and go into port. This artillery is going to go to South Australia using the strategic rail. In India, this infantry in southern India is going to march into Calcutta, and this motorized infantry in Maharashtra is going to drive to Calcutta. I'll tidy the whole thing up before I send the saveover. This transport in Maharashtra is going to move 3 spaces and go in port in South Africa. The Anzac destroyer and light cruiser in I-4 are going to move 2 spaces and join Force H in M8. We have a transport in Lower Egypt in the Red Sea port is going to go one into I-4, pick up the infantry British Somaliland, go back into the Red Sea and import and drop off the infantry in Lower Egypt. The infantry in Western Egypt is going to march into Lower Egypt. That concludes movements over there for the UK. Let's see, the transport in Gibraltar is going to move 3 spaces. And it's not going to go in port, it's going to join Force A. I'm just going to leave this in Ireland because I'm probably going to need it again at some point. Excuse me. You damn Irish. The transport in Gibraltar, I forgot to mark it, but it's going to fly to London. I think it can make it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it can make it to London. We have a light cruiser in Force A, which is going to move 3 spaces and go in port in Gibraltar. I knew I saved that for a good reason. And I think that just about concludes non-combat movement for the Commonwealth. Let me just have a quick look around. Pretty sure I got everything I wanted to get. Yeah, that looks about right. Okay, that will conclude non-combat movements for the Commonwealth, so we'll go to place new units. Okay, we'll just grab everybody east of Suez first. Okay, that's 1 AAA for Calcutta, and we will upgrade the minor factory to a medium factory in Sydney. Okay, the UK purchases. One infantry is going to go into Cape Town. And everyone else is going into London. So I'm just going to delete these two militia and these two militia up here for the upgrades. Copy these two infantry here. And drop them all off in London. Concludes placing the units. We go to collect income. UK collecting 14, FEC are on 5, and ANZAC are on 3. Up people over here. So the UK will have 16 spend next turn. FEC will have 6, and ANZAC will have 5. Okay, we go over to France. Start with our technology roll. We're going to, where have we got anything? What are we going to get? Well, we'll go for heavy armor. Doesn't really matter. I've never seen France complete the tech. Not to say that it hasn't happened or couldn't happen, but it doesn't matter anyway because I rolled a one. Okay, purchases. Oh, I've just. Oh, yeah, no, he's on the board, I remember. Okay, so France have eight to spend. We're going to spend all eight. We're going to purchase two infantry and two militia. We also have this foreign legion that we're going to place from the last turn. We unsuccessfully sent to the Abyssinians after they established their empire. So I'm just going to drop these guys off in the Mediterranean and I'll put them down later. Right, so combat moves. We have one combat move as France. We're going to send this minion bomber on map in A44. That includes combat moves. Non-combat moves. First, we'll do strategic naval. We've got this foreign legion and this transport. It's not going to be important actually because it's not a major port. I'm ready to miss that up. I'll leave it there. Move 5 spaces and drop the foreign legion off in French Guiana. Okay, that concludes strategic naval move. We've got two infantry and a transport in Syria. We're going to move over 2 spaces and drop off in Algeria. And the transport's going to go in port. I just looked over that's nationalist militia. I apologize. And I think that will actually conclude non-combat moves for France. Yes, that it will. Actually, no, we're going to put one French infantry is going to go into southern parts. Okay, that concludes. Oh, these submarines. We're going to go 1, 2, 3 and drop them over here in the Arabian Sea. Okay, that concludes non-combat movement. We're going to place new units. So we're going to place this Foreign Legion in northern Algeria. We're going to place two militia in Alsace-Lorraine, and two more French infantry are going to go into Paris. Anglo is placing the units. The French are collecting 9. And that will conclude the French turn. So now we head over to the Italians, which I believe is the captain. I just can't remember off the top of my head. I'm pretty sure it's the captain. But that concludes UK and Free France. Thank you very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next one, and I will say ta-ta for now.